r/AskReddit. What is your opinion on the moon? Not my opinion, but the opinion of the homeless guy at the 7-Eleven behind my apartment. We call him Nuke the Moon because that's all he ever talks about. He hates the moon. Can't grow anything in it. Can't build anything on it. No production of nutrition up there. He hates that smug orb in the sky. I'm commenting on his behalf. Nuke the moon. Edit, my RIP inbox stranger kind gold. Thanks. Gotta nuke something. Touche. Think about it, old folks home on the moon. 1/6 the gravity means arthritis and other muscular deterioration is gone. Environmental controls will have the perfect amount of oxygen pumped into rooms, no more air tanks. Most residents would need to terraform the moon like a garden or raise fish, perfect for old people. Technology will be advanced enough through holograms and haptic suits slash gloves will put you right in the living room of anyone that accepts your call. The giant railgun, normally used to send shuttles to Mars, could be used to launch the bodies of the deceased deep into the universe, or whatever direction you put in your will. Iron mine. Rest stop for Mars travelers. And an old folk home. But we know from the ice that prolonged time in lower gravity environments will cause rapid bone loss. So I suspect there would still be some serious issues. It would be a morbid race between the known degeneration that takes place in reduced gravity versus old people dying. She's beautiful. Soccer? My first girlfriend turned into the moon. I have a window in my shower and sometimes when I'm in there I can see the moon. Just makes me super happy every time I see it. Especially while bathing for some reason. Just feels right. And you're okay with the moon watching you shower through your window? You even enjoy it? This is the kind of degeneracy the moon gets up to. We must nuke the moon. For the children. You could say this Redditor enjoys mooning the moon. Same as it, as when I'm on Earth. It may carry less weight. But every bit as much mass. Edit, holy hit. My first Reddit silver. TYVM. Anonymous person. You're awesome. The moon is very comforting to me. Whenever you are staring at the moon, a stranger is also staring at the moon. You are sharing a moment with someone you may never meet. To add to this, everyone who has lived before us has seen the same moon as us. Bruh, stop looking at it at the same time as me. I ain't trying to have a moment with you. For this reason. Whenever I see the moon I say no homo. May or may not be made out of cheese. Maybe Wensleydale. Him bringing the crackers. I don't believe in the moon. I think it's just the back of the sun. But then again. I'm not like normal people. I don't have superpowers yet. Anyway. In my spare time. I enjoy stuffing animals. Usually with other animals. For instance, a badger will hold 5 squirrels. A squirrel will hold most of a cat. A mouse will hold a shrew and a vole. You get the idea, circle of life. I have broken the sound barrier. But you must never ask me how. Edit, I'm a little proud that my highest rated comment is a r/scrubs reference. This is the correct answer. Solid 7/10. Pros, big, white, pretty. Let's me know what time it is, day, night, const, no atmosphere, not enough water, pros, white, well alright then, I guess it's cool when it's not racism, huh, pros, big, honestly I was more offended that he basically called it fat, it's a menace and needs to be stopped, no you're thinking of Spider-Man, well I want pictures, you, the moon landing is fake, me, an intellectual, the moon is fake. Moon truth is unite. My first girlfriend turned into the moon. That's rough. Buddy. That's rough. Buddy. I know this isn't what you asked, but my 1-year-old doesn't have Reddit. He is ducking stoked by the moon. Every time we go outside he looks in the sky for it. Moon. Moon. And if he sees it. Hit is on. Moon. If the moon ever makes an appearance in a book or cartoon, he points it out to us about 23 times. Moon. Yes. The moon. Moon. Yes. The moon. We recently got him a book of the solar system, and he insists we count all 65 of Jupiter's moons. It's like my son wrote this question. He's going places. Hopefully the moon. Lol, too cute. Your son's obsession with the moon reminds me of the aliens in Toy Story and the Claw. I feel like he is a good president for South Korea. He has improved relations with the North over the past year. He also is moving towards a healthier Earth with using more and more reusable energy, but as well using more natural gas instead of nuclear and coal. More good things should come to Korea. Using more natural gas instead of nuclear. How is that a good thing? It's not. Nuclear is a clean source of energy and modern designs are very safe. Chernobyl and Fukushima happened because they stuck with cheaply made outdated designs instead of modernizing. We frankly need nuclear energy to replace coal and natural gas. In addition to using other green energies, natural gas gives off greenhouse gases, like all fossil fuels. The moon is imperative to our survival as humankind. If it were too far, the Earth would rotate as fast and our summers would be hell and our winters would be subarctic faster and cause our days to be about 6 hours long, as well as faster winds and stronger storms. If the moon is too close, our tides would be catastrophic. I'd say the moon is perfect exactly as it is. Edit. Thanks/you/Hunter Rothschildhaus. It's a little too perfect. I don't trust it. Especially since we only see its one side. I don't know what it's plotting on the other side. I bet that's where it hides all of its gold. So that the tricksy Earth can't try and take it. Never heard of it before. Me either, to be honest. Whenever people deny the moon landing, I make fun of them for even believing in the moon in the first place. We have the technology. The time is now. Science can wait no longer. Children are our future. America can. Should. Must. And will blow up the moon. We are spending all this money. Millions of dollars. To blow up the moon. When there are so many things here on Earth to blow up. Mount Everest. The North Pole. Etc. We are Earthlings. Let's blow up Earth things. The last person to walk on the moon in 1972, was born in 1934, and died in 2017. Nobody born after 1936 has ever walked on the moon. The first missions to the moon were accomplished with less computing power than you find in a mid-range cell phone today. What the hell? People. We should have cities there by now. The Wright brothers flew in 1903, and Yuri Gagarin flew to space 58 years later. Next year will be 58 years after Gagarin's flight. And we can just barely copy him. It's like if people in 1961 were still building Wright flyers for rich people to fly a few hundred feet. When I was growing up, a common saying was if they can put a man on the moon, they should be able to. Well, guess what? We can't put a man on the damn moon anymore. Well done, mankind. Well done. Lol, we can, it's just hella expensive. There's this Japanese billionaire who's planning to go up there in 2023 for a project called Dear Moon. Google it. When you have so much money that you run out of things to spend it on. That's Snow Moon. Scrolled way too far for this. It is a nice place to visit. But it never snows, so skiing is tough. The robot from Wallace and Gromit managed just fine. We like the moon. Cause it is close to us. We like the moon. But not as much as a spoon. Cause that's more use for eating soup. And a fork isn't very useful for that. Unless it has got many vegetables. And then you might be better off with a chopstick. Unlike the moon. It is up in the sky. It's up there very high. But not as high as maybe dirigibles or zeppelins. Or light bulbs. And maybe clouds. And puffins also, I think maybe. They go quite high too. Maybe not as high as the moon, cause the moon is very high. We like the moon. The moon is very useful, everyone. Everybody like the moon. Because it light up the sky at night. And it lovely. And it makes the tide go, and we like it. But not as much as cheese. We really like cheese. We like zeppelins. We really like them. And we like kelp, and we like moose. And we like deer, and we like marmots. And we like all the fluffy animals. We really like the moon. This was too far down the page. Too bad you hogged all the words though. And I couldn't participate. / I mean, there's no atmosphere. Any opinion I give wouldn't make a sound up there. Traps are gay, but there's nothing wrong with that. Too bad no one heard it. I'm proud of our moon. Sure. It's no Titan or Ganymede. But you can spend all day envying other planets' moons, and where's it gonna get you in the end? It's okay most of the time. But when the moon hits your eye like a big pizza pie, that's amor. We need to set up a colony on that Zambik as soon as possible. People like the idea of a colony on Mars, but we haven't even been there yet. We've been to the moon and it's close enough that it could have support from Earth. It's also got less gravity, so maybe we could build a space elevator there from known materials and use it as a launching point for space travel. It does alright, to be fair. Pretty cool, but could be cooler. If it was also in a geosynchronous orbit, then we'd have a solar and lunar eclipse every day. Fun fact, look at where the light side of the moon is pointing. If it's pointing above the horizon, then it's daytime. Now you have another way to tell if it's daytime when you can see the sky. It has craters. Someone's always got to chime in with the negative feedback. SMDH. Any hole's a hole, am I right? Ducking, like, and subscribe.